Hi friends, in this class we are going to discuss the properties of negative feedback. Properties of negative feedback. So generally, this topic can be otherwise called as effect of negative feedback or impact of negative feedback. Basically, there are five impacts or five properties of negative feedback. What are they? They are gain desensitivity, bandwidth extension, non-linear distortion reduction, noise reduction, an increase in input resistance, finally decrease in output resistance. So these five parameters or these five properties we are going to discuss in this class. First we see what is gain desensitivity. Now we discuss the properties one by one. First we take gain desensitivity. So why we are concerned this property is, generally the transfer gain of an amplifier is not constant. The gain is not constant because of aging of the transistor or temperature variations or replacement. So if you are already using one transistor, if it gets fault, you can replace the transistor. So due to the replacement, the characteristics will change. So these three parameters changes the transfer gain. So we have to make a characteristics called the desensitivity, so that the transistor's gain does not change due to the aging, temperature, replacement, etc. Okay. Now we read the text. The transfer gain of the amplifier is not constant. It depends on aging, temperature, replacement, etc. This lack of stability can be reduced by introducing negative feedback. So this unstable condition can be reduced by introducing a negative feedback. Now we get into the derivation part. First we have to take the expression, the gain with feedback. Already in the previous video we have seen AF is equal to A by 1 plus A beta, whereas the A, capital A, represents the open loop gain or basic amplifier's gain. Beta is the gain of the feedback network. AF is the gain of the amplifier with feedback. This can be taken as equation 1. Now, the equation 1 is differentiated with respect to A. So hence, DAF by DA is equal to, here we apply U by V, differentiation formula U by V. So hence, we have V, VDU minus UDV by V square. So finally, if we differentiate with respect to A, we have dA is nothing but 1. Finally, we have this expression DAF is equal to dA by 1 plus A beta whole square. In the next step, we are going to divide both the sides by AF. So DAF by AF is equal to, the expression we got here is divided by 1 by AF. So already we know AF is nothing but A by 1 plus A beta. This is reciprocal form. Hence, this square gets cancelled with this 1 plus A beta. Finally, we had DAF by AF is equal to 1 by 1 plus A beta dA by A. This is equation number 2. So what this term represents is fractional change in amplification with feedback. This expression is fractional change in amplifier without feedback. So this 1 plus A beta is nothing but amount of feedback. From equation 2, I can say the change in gain with feedback is less than the change in gain without feedback by a factor of 1 plus A beta. Hence, this factor is called as amount of feedback. Now we see what is sensitivity. Before defining desensitivity, we have to see what is sensitivity. So sensitivity is nothing but the fractional change in amplifier with feedback divided by the fractional change in amplifier without feedback. The sensitivity is nothing but the ratio of fractional change in amplifier with feedback to the fractional change in amplifier without feedback. So here we have specified DAF, AF is nothing but fractional change in amplification with feedback. Hence, the numerator will have modulus of DAF by AF, and in the denominator we have modulus of DA by A, that is equivalent to 1 plus A beta. From this we are making this form. So this is the sensitivity. So what is desensitivity? The reciprocal of this sensitivity is called the desensitivity. So what is the reciprocal of this? 1 plus A beta. Now we can say the stability of the amplifier increases with the increase in desensitivity. So desensitivity is the main factor which decides the stability of your amplifier. What happens if your desensitivity nature of your amplifier is increased? Your amplifier will be stable. Now in this expression, if we consider A beta is nothing but a loop gain. If the loop gain is very greater than 1, this AF can become as 1 by beta. That means the gain is purely dependent on the feedback network's gain. It does not depend on the gain of basic amplifier. So what happens is, if we remove the dependency of A for the gain of feedback with amplifier, the thing is 1 by beta means we are eliminating the A value. So what is the benefit we achieve here is, we does not depend on the value of A. The value of A will affect the stability of your amplifier. Okay, hence we can write the gain may be made to depend entirely on the feedback network. What is feedback network's gain? That is nothing but beta. The next property we discuss is bandwidth extension. So due to the introduction of negative feedback, the bandwidth is increased. So how it is increased, we can use some derivations to prove this. So first of all, introduction of the negative feedback in the amplifier increases the bandwidth. We know that the gain with feedback for an amplifier is AF. So we take this expression AF is equal to A by 1 plus A beta. Now we write three different equations using this expression for lower frequency, for higher frequency and the mid frequency. So for mid frequency, we specify AF mid is equal to A mid divided by beta into A mid. This is equation 1. Next, we write AF low for low frequency, A low by 1 plus beta A low. For high frequency, AF high is equal to A high by 1 plus A high. Next, we have to find the lower cutoff frequency FLF. That means lower frequency with feedback and upper frequency with feedback. Okay. For this, we take the relationship between gain of lower cutoff frequency and mid cutoff frequency. So for finding upper cutoff frequency, we take the relationship between high gain and mid gain. So A low by A mid can be written as 1 by 1 minus J into FL by FF. So FL by F. Hence, we can write A low is equal to A mid by 1 minus J FL by F. So this equation can be written as 4. Similarly, for upper cutoff frequency, there will be a minor change. That is, we have the plus value here. So A high is equal to A mid by 1 plus J into F by FH. So this is the equation 7. Okay, we continue the derivation. AF low is equal to, so we substitute the fourth equation in the equation number 2. What is equation number 2? So this is equation number 2, that is AF low is equal to A low by 1 plus A beta A low. So here we are going to introduce the fourth equation value, A mid by 1 minus J into FL by F. So what happens? We continue the derivation. So here AF low is equal to A mid by 1 minus J into FL by F divided by 1 plus beta into the term what we written in the equation number 2 has written here. So finally, similarly, in for AF high, we are substituting the equation number 7 in third equation. Hence, we get two different types. We are put as a table to compare these two because similar steps are followed here. Now, we perform next dividing both numerator and denominator by 1 plus A mid beta. So, hence, we have AF low is equal to A mid by 1 plus A mid beta by 1 minus J into FL by F into 1 plus A mid beta. So this entire term can be replaced with AF mid divided by 1 minus J, this remaining parameters. So here this is justification. Since AF mid is equal to A mid by 1 plus A mid beta, similar things can be written for higher frequency also. Now we come to the relationship. AF low divided by AF mid is equal to 1 minus J into FLF by F. So what is FLF? What we are doing? We are replacing this term FL by 1 plus this term, FL by 1 plus A mid beta as FLF. So we can write where the lower cutoff frequency with feedback is given as FLF is equal to FL by 1 plus A mid beta. Similar thing we can write for upper frequency. So what happened? FHF is equal to 1 plus A mid beta into FH. So here we are going to take this entire term as a FH. So FHF can be written as 1 plus A mid beta into FH. From this we write two statements. Thus we can say that lower cutoff frequency with feedback is less than the lower cutoff frequency without feedback by a factor of 1 plus A mid beta. This term is very important. You have to specify in the while answering for this question, by a factor of 1 plus A mid beta. Similarly, for higher cutoff frequency, you can say the upper cutoff frequency with feedback is greater than the upper cutoff frequency without feedback by a factor of 1 plus A mid beta. So FHF is incremented with FH by the factor of this. The lower frequency, the lower frequency available for amplifier without feedback is reduced due to the factor of 1 plus A mid beta. Okay. So from this I can infer, by introducing the negative feedback, low frequency response of the amplifier is improved. By introducing the negative feedback, high frequency response of the amplifier is improved. Now we get into the bandwidth, calculation of the bandwidth. What happened? Generally, we write the bandwidth of the amplifier with feedback can be written as BWF is equal to FHF minus FLF. So, what is FHF? 1 plus A mid beta into FH minus FLF can be written as FL by 1 plus A mid beta due to the condition. Normally, the high frequency is FH, that is very greater than FL. Hence, this entire term is eliminated. So, we have 1 plus A mid beta into FH. This FH is otherwise written as BW, because for BW, FH minus FL, what here we consider, this term will be eliminated because of the higher value. Hence, BW can be replaced with FH. So, this is replaced, the FH is replaced with bandwidth without feedback. Next, we have to draw the frequency response graph. So, in the y-axis, we have gain. In the x-axis, we have frequency. So, this is the frequency response for the amplifier without feedback. So, this response is due to the application of the feedback. So, this is the minus 3 dB frequency. From this, we take the frequency value, that is the lower frequency. So, this is the higher frequency for amplifier without feedback. So, here we have the lower frequency with feedback and higher frequency with feedback. From this diagram, I can say the bandwidth with feedback is larger than the bandwidth of the amplifier without feedback. So, the statement described here is FHF minus FLF is greater than FH minus FL. Hence, the bandwidth of the amplifier with feedback is greater than the bandwidth of the amplifier without feedback. Okay, next thing we have to consider the gain bandwidth product. So, for considering with feedback, the gain will be decreased but the bandwidth will be increased. Similarly, without feedback, the gain will be increased and the bandwidth will be decreased. When we consider the bandwidth product, gain bandwidth product, both are same. Here, this decreases, this is increases. In that part, it increases and this decreases.